Hi friends, now we'll discuss about spring force and work done by spring force. Now when spring force is developed in a spring, let's assume one end of spring is fixed on the wall like this. Say this one is the wall and one end of spring is fixed and other end of spring is free. Say small mass is attached. Now one end is fixed and other end is free. It is not subjected to any external force. There is no external compressive or external tensile force acting on the spring. Then such a length of spring in which it is not subjected to any compression, any elongation, such length of spring, say if we'll represent by LO, is called as free length of spring. It is called as free length of spring, or this length is also called as undeformed length of spring, also called as undeformed length, or also called as unstretched length. Or unstretched length. That means free length of spring. Length of spring when it is not subjected to any compression or any tensile force. Then the length of spring is called as free length. Now let's assume here one end is fixed as it is. Now to other end some external force is applied so that now spring elongates and we'll get now end of spring somewhere here. Now what we are getting here, some external force is acting. Work done by external forces, you know how to find out the force into displacement. But here to this end external force is acting or applied in rightward direction so that spring elongates. Now when spring elongates, we are interested in what spring force is developed or how spring force is developed. Once external force is applied, spring elongates. Now we are getting some new position. Say this one is position 1. After this much elongation at position 1, now if external force is removed, what happens? This end again moves in leftward direction and comes to its original length. Now this end moves in leftward direction. This is due to what? So due to this deformation, say at this position 1, if I write deformation by x at position 1 means x1, due to this elongation of spring or deformation of spring, at the end what spring force acts in leftward direction, right? And such a force which one is developed due to deformation is called as spring force. Magnitude of the spring force depends on this deformation. As the deformation increases, magnitude of spring force developed increases. This deformation may be elongation, may be compression of spring. Whenever deformation is there, spring force is developed. Therefore, what will get here? The spring force what is developed in a spring is directly proportional to deformation. Where spring force, if I'll represent by Fs, equal to this deformation I'll write by x. What will get here? Some constant of proportionality k, where this Fs spring force is in Newton, deformation of spring is in meters. Therefore, unit of k must be Newton per meter. This k is called as spring constant. This k is called as a spring constant, or this one is also called as stiffness of spring. Stiffness of spring, or this one also called as modulus of spring. This is also called as modulus of spring, where unit of this spring constant k is newtons per meter. So that this is in newton per meter. This is deformation in meter, Newton per meter into meter, meter gets cancelled. That means spring force what will get is in Newton. As deformation of spring increases, magnitude of spring force developed increases. Now here what we have done, external force is applied, spring deforms or elongates by x1, right? If external force is removed and moves towards left and again it comes to its original shape or original length, what will get again? Free length. Now if again external force what is applied, that one continues. I'll represent here some positions, here some more position. Now again external force continues, so this spring elongates and what will get here, say this one is again one more position, say position 2. Deformation of spring is always measured from undeformed position. So as undeformed state is this end, length is L0, deformation is measured from this undeformed state. Similarly, here if you want to represent what is the deformation at this position 2, so from this undeformed state, here what deformation will get here, I'll represent it by x2. Now spring force acts in leftward direction, end of spring moves in rightward direction. Therefore, in this case, work done if you want to find out, so this displacement from 1 to 2 is x2 minus x1. But you can't take work done by spring force as what, Fs into x2 minus x1. Reason is what? Magnitude of spring force what is developed here is kx1. At this position, magnitude of spring force what is developed is kx2. That means during this displacement, magnitude of spring force doesn't remain constant. As magnitude of spring force doesn't remain constant, you can't apply directly equation as force into displacement, where magnitude of force is variable, therefore you have to use some integration method. If you use integration method, I will assume it's some intermediate position where deformation of spring at this position is say x, general any x deformation. At this position, spring force if we'll represent on this end of spring, magnitude of spring force is Fs, which is k into x, and direction of spring force is leftward. But this end of spring moves in rightward direction, will take small displacement as dx, where this one is say again new position. For this small displacement, displacement dx is very small, so that what magnitude of spring force will get, that one will assume as a constant, and for this small displacement will find out work done by spring force. As we were interested in work done by spring force when it moves from 1 to 2, we'll integrate this equation, and from that one we'll get work done by spring force when it moves from position 1 to 2. Now for this small displacement, if you want to find out what is work done, spring force is acting in leftward direction, displacement is in rightward direction. As a direction of spring force and direction of displacement are opposite, work done by spring force is negative. Therefore, you see on next page, work done by spring force for small displacement dx, for small displacement dx is what? This spring force Fs into dx, where this one I'll write with minus sign. Why it is negative? Direction of spring force and direction of displacement are opposite. Displacement is same, small displacement dx, therefore work done I will write by dw. Now equal substituted value of Fs, means spring force, which one is k into x into displacement is what, dx, what will get? Work done dw. Now if you want to find out work done when end of spring moves from position 1 to 2, that means total work done from position 1 to position 2. This work done, you will get, if we'll integrate this small work done for small displacement dx, therefore integral of minus kx dx, where this x varies from x1 to x2, or deformation varies from x1 to x2. At position 1, deformation of spring is x1. At position 2, deformation of spring is x2. Therefore, W is equal to integral of kx dx, k is constant, integral of x dx is x square by 2. Therefore, can you say it is minus k and half x square, where x varies from x1 to x2. That means this one is written as minus k by 2. Upper limit, if we'll substitute, upper limit is x2. Therefore, x2 square minus lower limit is x1. What will get here? X1 square. Therefore, work done by spring force when end of spring moves from position 1 to 2. If we'll multiply here by this negative term, to minus minus x2 term, that becomes what? Negative, and x1 square term becomes positive. Therefore, half k x1 square minus x2 square. What you are getting here? Work done by spring force. That means, in short, work done by spring force, if you want to find out, when end of spring moves from position 1 to 2, where deformation varies from x1 to x2, is given by W equal to half k x1 square minus x2 square. In work done by the spring force, this term k and x1, x2 are important. Whenever we will substitute values here, k must be substituted in newtons per meter, x1 and x2 must be in meters. Therefore, whenever we will solve any problem, then units are very important. Always we will substitute this k always in newtons per meter, and this x1 and x2, these deformations always will substitute in meters, so that we'll get correct answer. Sometimes what happens, k may be given in newton per centimeter, x1 and x2 are in centimeters. What unit will get? Newton per centimeter into centimeter square. 1 centimeter gets cancelled and we'll get work done in newton centimeter. But newton centimeter, if you take as a work done, on another side, kinetic energy is always in terms of, in what units? Newton meter. Therefore, while substituting values, x1, x2 may be given in mm, k in newton per mm, but will not substitute as it is value. Sometimes we will feel k is in newton per mm and deformations are in mm, that means what will calculate is correct. But unit of work done, what will get in this case is newton mm, and on another side, what unit of kinetic energy will get, that is newton meter. Therefore, you will get wrong answer. Whenever we will solve any problem while finding work done by spring force, always we will substitute k in newton per meter and x1 and x2 in meters. Again, x1 is always initial deformation of spring at position 1. X2 represents what? Final deformation of spring at position 2. That means, while solving problem, finding x1 and x2 are very important. We will just find out x1 and x2 for one simple case. Let's see next page. Suppose a free length of spring is given. Free length equal to, say, 250 millimeters. Maybe one end of spring is connected at this position, say point A. Spring is in a horizontal position. Its other end here, what is given is a slider. Where slider moves, you can say, in downward direction. Now this length of spring, say 300 millimeters, and when spring moves from this position 1 now to position 2 by, say, displacement of 400 millimeters. This one is in mm and this one is also in millimeter. Now this is position 1 and if next position is position 2. Next position 2, here I will represent. See to it there are no two spring. What I represented is what? Single spring, but at two different positions. Now this one end of spring is A, which one is connected to wall or to some hinge. Say this point is B and this point is C. Now free length of spring is 250 mm. What length of spring you are getting at position 1 AB is 300 mm, called as actual length of spring at position 1. That means spring is in elongated state, because free length is 250 mm, length of spring is what? 300 mm. Therefore at position 1, now deformation, if you want to find out, say x1 is difference between actual length of spring and free length of spring. Actual length of spring is AB, free length is what? Say FL. AB length is 300 mm, free length of spring is 250 mm, what you will get here is 50 mm. Similarly at position 2, now x2, if you want to find out, you must know length of spring, actual length of spring, that is AC minus free length. Now actual length of spring, AC, if you want to find out, we will use Pythagoras theorem, 300 mm and 400 mm. That means this length of spring, what you will get if you calculate, is what? 500 mm. Now deformation of spring at this position 2 is what? Actual length of spring, that is AC, is what? 500 mm. Free length of spring is 250 mm. Therefore, what deformation of spring will get is 250 mm. Like this, we will find out deformations at any position. Now in this case, length of spring is greater than free length. That means what deformations we are getting? These are elongations. If you will get deformation of spring, maybe in compression, that means length of spring is less than free length, then also deformation x1 and x2 always will take positive. Though it is in elongated state or in compressed state, deformation, only magnitude of deformation will write. Because negative sign for compression, if we'll take, then that direction of spring force will change. And while Dirac formula of work done by spring force, we have considered direction of displacement and direction of spring force. Therefore, important point is what? Deformation of spring means difference between free length and actual length of spring, and is always positive. Spring may be in elongated state or spring may be in compressed state. Thank you.